Well, starting tomorrow, we are about exactly a month away from the second annual Heart Chase through the American Heart Association in Traverse City. Before we talk about the event, though, I want to introduce Lori Zemsta. Lori is on the board for the Heart Chase along with myself. She's involved heavily in Heart Chase and has a very personal connection to heart disease that goes back to when you were 9 years old, Lori.
Yes. My dad died when I was 9 years old, and he was only 40 years old from complications of heart disease. And I had two brothers. My younger brother died at 36. My older brother had a heart attack at 32 and died at 55 of a heart attack. Just before I started having my symptoms in spinning class at the gym, a little bit of tightness in my chest. Again, I ignored it, just like most women do. I had a lot of pain in my back. I kept telling my boss he had to replace his chair. I had some jaw pain. And it took me about 2 months before I finally went to my doctor, who just kind of patted my hand and said, you know, you're young, you're a woman, it's probably nothing, it's musculoskeletal. And I said, you know, I've been going to the gym for a long time, and I know what musculoskeletal pain feels like, and this is different. So to appease me, he said, okay, we'll do a nuclear stress test,
okay,
which I failed. And that sent me directly to a cardiologist and the heart cath, and I had a 98% blockage in my LAD, which is your large... 98%. He said he couldn't even get the little catheter through to put a stent in. He couldn't do anything. He said, you're going right to surgery. Didn't even let me leave the hospital, right to surgery for a triple bypass. So he had told my husband later that I would have been dead within the year, and probably at a gym class.
That gives me chills.
Yes.
And you were doing what every person thinks they're supposed to do to prevent heart disease. You were doing physical activity.
Yes.
When you started having these symptoms.
Yes, but for me, it runs in the family. My whole family had high cholesterol. Mm-hmm. I've had high cholesterol for many years, but I'm on medication, and they're controlling it now, and I've been great since then.
And obviously, this has led to your connection to heart disease.
Yes, and it's so important, especially for us women whose symptoms are so different. Pain in the back, pain in your jaw, I thought I had a bad tooth. It's so important to have women aware of their symptoms and to be proactive in their health, to get to the doctor, and don't let them just brush you off to get that help that you need and get the testing that you need.
And that's why the American Heart Association created this newer event. It's only in its second year.
Yes.
Traverse City had the pilot program, and you can see right here, it's about a month from today, Saturday, August 11th. Starts at 9 in the morning, goes to about noon. It starts at the open space. Registration is open. That is the key right now to get registered. I'm going to be taking part. I'm actually the chair of the event, so this is one of my big passions right now.
Yes.
Heart disease is the number one killer of men and women. We say it all the time, but it is. Lori will be there. Lori's on the board with me, so we're still kind of getting everything underway.
Yes.
But it's amazing. The event really has a lot of heart information, how to live a heart-healthy lifestyle, and you are a perfect example, Lori, of why you need to take your symptoms seriously.
Absolutely. Yes, all women, especially women, and men too, but for me it's a personal thing with women, that they take that seriously, they get to their doctor, and they get the testing they need.
Well, I'm glad you got that testing. So
yes, thank you. Me
thank
too.
Thank you so much for
thank
being
you for having
here.
Me here.
Absolutely.
I appreciate it.
And of course, for more information on the second annual Heart Chase taking place in a month, Saturday, August 11th, check out our website, upnorthlive.com. And switching gears now, taking a look at weather this morning, here's Storm Team Meteorologist Christina Burkhart.